Rocco, I'm number 20. I'm a junior and I'm a guard.
Alexa Holland, junior guard, number 10.
Ali Larkin, junior guard, number 30.
Bailey Abbott, senior forward, number 24.
Hi, I'm Keaton Stasia. I'm a junior and I'm a forward, number 12.
Grace Pfeiffer, freshman guard, number 14.
Alexis Elliott, freshman guard, number 22.
Kennedy Moseman, freshman center, 44.
Morgan Ruff, freshman guard, number 32.
I'm Alexa Garrison, number 40, and a sophomore forward.
Emma Dahlquist, freshman center, number 54.
It'll be Collins and Abbott to jump center. Rochester will go right to left, and Lewis Cass left to right. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. The ball is up. The tip controlled by Lewis Cass. Thompson runs to the right, lobs down low to McLean. McLean tops the key to Thompson, fakes a three, gives to Collins. She'll fire a three from the right wing. It's short. Rebound offensively knocked out of bounds by Rochester. And it's going to stay with Lewis Cass as Weaver grabbed the board, and the Lady Zebras knocked it out of bounds. Grimmelspacher will look to get it in. Grimmelspacher over the top of the defense to Thompson. Holds high on the right side. Cross court left to Collins. Collins, wrap around pass, dribble pass, and gets it back. One pass again. Gets it out to McLean, who is fouled going to the basket. And it'll be out of bounds to Lewis Cass. And the first team foul coming against Rochester.
So Becky Malco going to pick up her first foul.
Baseline left is McLean. Gets it into Collins. She'll take the 18-long foot shot. No good. Holland with the rebound. Ahead to Malco. Drives the baseline. Wrap around past the Stasiak. Through her legs. Ball loose. Cass picks it up. And now McLean has it. McLean runs it up the floor for Lewis Cass. Works to the right side of the basketball floor. Grimmelspacher runs the baseline against the double team. Travels. No call. Gives outside to McLean, her jumper from the free throw line is no good, and then Lewis Cass knocks it out of bounds, and Rochester going to get it back.
So right away, you can see Lewis Cass a much better ball handling team than some of the other schools we've seen so far this season.
Yeah, don't let the 1-4 record deceive you.
No, yeah, and they are quick.
Against full court press, Holland back to Larkin, crosses through the center circle, now high on the right side of Malco. Jump stop outside the Holland left wing. She'll fire a three from the left side. No good off the mark. Offensive rebound for the Lady Zebras. Malco has it. She'll take the 15-footer off the back of the iron. No good. Ball tipped around. Malco has it in the end of the lane. Outside to Larkin. Larkin drives it left. Now pulls it back outside. Dump down pad. Dump down low to Bailey Abbott, who is drilled by Weaver. It'll be out of bounds to Rochester. Baseline left.
That was had the look of a ill-advised pass.
Yeah.
Zebras came out the better as Weaver picked up the foul, but they looked like they had that shut down pretty well.
Larkin on the left wing, now backs it out, reset for Rochester, left side to Holland. X now to Larkin at the volleyball line. Back to Holland, left side. She'll fire another three from the wing. No good again. Stasiak with the rebound. Keaton's shot over Weaver's good, and the foul!
Nice job by Keaton Stasiak. Not only was she able to get position for the good rebound, she tried to work herself into a position to throw the ball back outside when nobody came open. She just went right on around the corner and made the layup.
Keaton fires a free throw. It's good, and Rochester up 3-0. Full court press, man-to-man press, I should say, by Rochester. Thompson brings it up quickly back to McLean. McLean on the block to Weaver. One dribble outside of Thompson. Long three for the Lady Kings. No good. Draws nothing but air. And Collins saves him going out of bounds right in the hands of Stasiak. Keaton runs, and then she is fouled by Thompson, who is riding her up the court. And that's going to send Coach Collins to his bench immediately to bring in Aubrey Young, a 5'9 junior, for the Lady Kings.
Well, Weaver with two fouls. Thompson picked up her first.
Weaver has two? No kidding.
Yeah. So Weaver will come out.
Rochester will have it at the timeline, the far side of the floor, as Malco will walk it up and will cross the timeline against Lewis Kansas 2-3 zone at the volleyball line now. High on the right side to Malco. Back to Malcolm now to Larkin, to Stasiak. Keaton in the lane, rises up, shot blocked by Collins. And now Cass on the break. McLean double dribbles, no call. Gives it to Thompson, her floating jumper is good. And now four court press by the Kings. Keaton Stasiak travels.
So Collins is listed at 5'9", but she is deceptively bigger than that.
Yeah, I would say she's bigger than 5'9".
Yeah.
So after the Rochester turnover, the Kings have it right in front of the student section. And Thompson will run the point for Lady Kings against the man-to-man defense. Collins for three and the lead. Good! 5-3 Rochester. Morgan Ruff will come in for Rochester. Cast in a full court press. Rochester breaks it. Holland on the right side of the lane. Pulls up from 17 feet. She gets it to go. We're tied at 5. Cass runs the other way. McLean through the center circle. Splits the double team. Loses the handle. Stasiak picks it up. Gives the head to Holland. Cross lane pass to Larkin. Her layup is good. Rochester up 7-5. Timeout, Lewis Cass. 5:15 to play in the first quarter. It's a 30. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI. 5:15 to play in the first quarter. Rochester back up 7-5. And after the Lewis Cass timeout, they've got it going to our right. Run and jump defense, the trap defense in half court. Gives to Collins. One dribble over the top of the defense to McLean. McLean, right-handed layup down the middle of the lane is good. And we're tied at 7. As half-court trap did not work for Rochester's defense. Holland to Larkin. Gives ahead to Malco. Left side of the floor. Drives it inside the three-point line. Looks to dump it down low. Can't because the defense took away the passing lane to Ruff. Morgan Ruff drives and is going to be fouled on the drive by Lewis Cass. And is that going to be on Thompson? No. I'll do it for you.
Grimble's pocket.
4:43 to play in the first quarter. Malco, left side to Holland. X inside the three-point line, backs it out. Now to Gibbs to Ruff on the left baseline. Morgan, a couple of passes to Malco, quickly to Larkin. Looks at the three, one dribble, back to Malco. Quickly left side to Holland. Malco behind the arc, right side. Drives into paint, stops, pops. No good. Bailey Abbott fights for the rebound, and it's going to go out of bounds. They're going to say last touch by Lewis Cass. Rochester will keep possession. 4:22 to play in the first quarter. We're tied at 7. Rochester basketball out of bounds, baseline right. Holland looks. Bounce pass into Malco. Malco before the shot is fouled, and Rochester will have it out of bounds. And I believe McLean will pick up that foul.
Yep. Number 21, Ashton.
4:21 to play in the first quarter. 7-7, Rochester basketball. Holland will trigger it inbounds. Ooh, she missed. Yep.
Abbott.
On the baseline to Malco. Outside to Holland for a 15-footer. Nope, too hard, and the rebound to Collins. Collins gives the head to McLean. Cass runs. Middle of the floor is McLean. Now left side, Grimmelschmacher. Fakes, drives, outside to Thompson. She'll fire a three from the left wing. It's in and out, no good. Rebound by Thompson. Her putback is off the window and good. That's what you call following your shot and getting a garbage bucket. Lewis Cass up 9-7. Cass in a full court press. Holland breaks the press, middle of the floor, fakes the pass, shot no good. Abbott with the rebound. Her putback is no good, but a foul coming on Lewis Cass, and that's going to send Bailey Abbott to the line to shoot two.
That foul's on Aubrey Young, her first.
Aubrey Young.
Team sixth.
Keaton will come back in after this first free throw by Abbott. Bailey fires the first one. No good, tries it off the side of the rim. Back in is Keaton. And Alexa Holland will come out. 3:47 to play in the first quarter. Lewis Cass up 9-7, and Bailey Abbott with one more freebie for the Lady Zebras. Bailey ready. Eyes a second one. Lets it fly. High arcing shot with no rotation. Does not go. Rebound to Collins, and she gives off to McLean. Lewis Cass runs right side of the floor. Here comes a double team. McLean runs away from it. Outside to Collins for a wide open three off the mark. No good. Stasiak into the board. She rips and gives to Malco. Malco brings up the right side of the floor. Now at the elbow right. Got to get rid of it. Finally does to Larkin behind the arc in the right wing. Larkin now backs it out and resets for Rochester. In the corner to Malco. She fakes the shot. Drives. Cut off on the blocks outside to Russ. Swings the left side to Larkin. She'll fire a three for Lady Zebras. Off the mark. No good. Malco with a rebound on the weak side. Malco bounce past the rough top of the key, fakes the three, drives in the lane, loses the handle, loses the footing. Stasiak on the floor with Lewis Cass. We're going to be tied up. Rochester will keep possession.
Well, one thing the Lady Kings do real well is move with the basketball. That defense comes out high on the perimeter when it's out front, and when it swings to the wings, they're right there with the pressure.
Malco will look to trigger it in, baseline right. Abby over the top of the defense to Ruff. Between the rings, swings right side to Larkin. 3 minutes to play, first quarter. Lewis Cass up 9-7. Malco in the left corner, dribbles to the wing. Over the top of the defense, right wing to Larkin. Down low to Stasiak, keeping the lane. Drives to the basket, throws up a shot. It's good, it was tied at 9. Bounced about three times on the rim and finally fell through. That's a good shot because that went up over Collins.
Yeah,
or around Collins, I should say. Collins across court to Thompson. To Young, jumper in the paint is good.
And you see how well the Kings move the basketball themselves. They don't hold it for long.
Full court press by the Lady Kings. Malco has it back to Larkin. Larkin a couple of dribbles. Now back to Malco on the right side. Still need to get it across the court timeline. Larkin finally does through the center circle of Stasiak. Stasiak loses a handle. Actually, they're going to say last touch by Lewis Cass. And Rochester will keep possession baseline right. Down by two with 2:22 to play in the first quarter. Holland will come back into the game. And coming out will be Larkin. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. 2:22 to play in the first quarter. Rochester down by two.
The early pace of this game has the makings of a track meet.
Holland, baseline right. Gets it into Malco in the right corner. Becky, bounce pass top of the key to Ruff. Quickly to X. X rises up. 10-footer, no good. Stasiak, weak side rebound. Now to Malco, top of the key to Larkin. Or makes that for Ruff. Back to X, now to Malco. Three, left wing, no good. Gets her own rebound in the paint. She goes back up before the shot. Or on the shot. We're going to be on the shot.
And that foul's on Young, her second. It's a belt and a bonus.
Yeah, before the shot, I beg your pardon. And Becky Malco with the line to shoot one and the bonus with 2:05 to play in the first quarter. Malco eyes the first one, lets it fly, and it's good. She has one more to try to tie the score to 11. Again, 2:05 to play in the first quarter. Becky Malco, one of the many juniors, fires the second one. Good again as it rattles in. Tied at 11. Little man-to-man press put on by Rochester. McLean travels. No, actually, she got away with it. Now ahead to Collins. Collins over the top of the defense to McLean, and she travels that time.
Holland probably could have had that ball. She'd have just turned around. Kind of lobbed that in up over her head.
She logged it.
Yeah.
Next time that happens, she'll grab it.
Yeah.
Minute 40, a minute 50 to play in the first quarter. Holland to Ruff. Rochester finally crosses the timeline to Malco. Over the top of the defense to Stasiak. Keaton drives it around Collins. Blocked from behind. Abbott picks it up. She's fouled on the shot. She'll go to the line to shoot two.
And Young's going to pick up her third.
A minute 39 to play in the first quarter. We're tied at 11. And Bailey Abbott will go to the line to shoot two for the Lady Zebras.
For the Zebras, shooting two, number 24, Bailey Abbott.
Abbott, two dribbles. Eyes the first one. Lets it fly. Off the side of the rim. No good. She'll have one more. And the JV wins tonight, 44-28. Alexa Garrison will come back into the game. Abbott's second one. Good this time. Rochester up 12-11. Garrison in. Abbott out. A minute 39 to play in the first quarter. Rochester by one. And now we'll be in a full court press. McLean has it over the top of the defense, and Cass almost turns it over. Now does. Malco has it and is drilled hard by Young. That's number four on Young.
Number four on Young, and we're still in the first quarter.
Gaswell, number 14.
Keaton's going to have to come out. She's got a little blood on her knee.
Checking in with the Zebras. Number 30, Allie Larkin. For Cass, number 34.
So at the free throw line is Becky Malco. Yeah, I got a feeling that Coach Collins and Lewis Cass only had six.
Yeah, they're not very deep.
Malco's free throw no good, and the rebound to Grimmelsbacher gives off down to McLean. She walks it up for Cass. Crossover dribble takes from the lane, goes to the basket. Her pass dumped down low to Himmerkow. Himmerkow's in the game. Holland across the timeline. Cast up by one. Left side to Malco. Becky holds the basketball. 5 feet away from the three-point line. Now works middle of the floor. High on the right side to Larkin to X. Holland against a double team. Outside to Malco at the volleyball line. Left side to Ruff. Ruff fakes the pass left. Now throws back to Malco. High on the right side. And remit to play in the first quarter. Lewis cast by one. 13-12. Holland high on the right side. Malco top of the key. Left side to Larkin. Alley, couple of dribbles, back to Holland, now right side to Malco. Malco in the lane. Top to Ruff, swings left side to Holland, now in the corner to Larkin. Alley with 40, picks up her dribble over the top of the defense to Holland, now to Malco, quickly left side to Larkin. She'll fire a three with 30, and it's good!
Great ball movement by the Lady Zebras. They kept working around the perimeter until they found an open shot.
Rochester by two. Collins outside of Grimmelsbacher, and she is fouled by Ruff.
You tell me if Collins travels when she gets the basketball.
She grabs it, hops a little bit, then makes a play.
Yeah.
So it'll be Lewis Cass basketball right in front of the Rochester bench. 22 seconds to play. First quarter, Rochester by two. Grimmelsbacher gets it in to Thompson. Thompson works to the left side of the floor. Rochester in a 2-3 zone. Outside to Collins. Collins over the top of the key to McLean. Her jumper is no good with 10. Ruff with the rebound. Ruff runs with 8. Morgan Ruff through the center circle with 6. Left side to Holland with 5. Holland with 4. Fire a 3. It's off the back of the rim. No good. And that'll do for the first quarter. After 1, Rochester leads 15-13. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
After 64 years serving this community, B&B Menswear of Rochester is closing their doors. Now is the time to save on all men's apparel as they liquidate their inventory. Take advantage of their store-wide savings on slacks, shirts, shoes, and more. Stop in today to see Phil, John, or Margaret as the B&B store clears its inventory of their name brand menswear. B&B store is going out of business and passing the savings on to you. Stop by today and save. Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester is the place for all of your automotive service needs.
I've been coming to Shepherd's for service approximately 5 or 6 years. My husband drives the Honda. 2004, I believe, so it isn't brand new. And he brings it here. We get our tires here, oil changes, whatever needs to be done, they take care of. We have a good history with the Shepherd family, so we're happy to come here.
Second quarter we go with the Rochester Lady Zebras leading 15-13. The Cass Kings will start the second period with the basketball. Thompson, the center circle, high on the left side to Grimmelsmacher. Grimmelsmacher, a couple of dribbles, now right side to McLean. McLean fakes the pass, now drives it right in the corner to Collins, who travels, no call. And the pass into the block is knocked out of bounds by Stasiak. Did you see her?
I wasn't watching that time.
Grimmelsmacher, baseline right, looks to trigger it in. Grimmelsmacher looking over the top of the defense, and now Morgan Ruff steals it. Ruff, middle of the floor for Rochester. Now works right side of the lane. Throws up an air shot. No good. Holland with the rebound. X backs it out. She'll take the 15-footer left baseline. No good. Ball being tipped around. And Weaver comes out of there with it. McLean now will bring it up against Holland. McLean through the center circle. Now over behind Brack dribble. Works right. Now back to the left side. Thompson quickly to Weaver on the back baseline. Thompson back to Weaver. Weaver stands on the three-point line. Left side of the floor. Back to Thompson. High on the left side. Drives. Gives to Weaver. Weaver. Now to Collins between the rings. Collins holds. Now left side to Thompson. Thompson fakes. Drives in the paint. Throws up a teardrop shot. It's no good. And Larkin to the rebound. Weaver is not going to look for her shot. Not even
no,
a...
She's not. Drop off of her and double-team Collins.
I'm not even sure if Lewis Katz has 4 scores on the floor right now. You know they don't have 5.
Right.
Larkin just inside the arc. Jumper's off the mark. No good. And the rebound to Grimmelsmacher. And the outlet pass to McLean. McLean against Holland. 6:40 to play. First half, Rochester by 2. And McLean across the timeline now for Cass. High on the left side to Thompson. Thompson, Grimmelsmacher between the rings against Larkin in the man-to-man defense. Now down low to Thompson. Her 8-footer is no good. And Ruff with the rebound and run. Morgan Ruff, right side of the floor, takes her all the way to the wing. Now to Larkin. Larkin fakes the 3, couple of dribbles to Holland. X back to Larkin behind the arc, right wing. Top of the key now. Left side to Ruff. Fakes the 3, yeah, drives, Ruff and she's going to travel. Malco come back into the game.
Checking back in with the Zebras.
And Morgan to come out. Hannah O'Dell will come in for the first time tonight for Rochester.
I think both teams starting to feel that first quarter pace a little bit here.
It was quick.
Beginning of the second quarter.
Bailey Abbott come out.
Shots aren't falling, and more of the young ladies are looking like they're trying to catch their breath.
Yeah. 6:15 to play in the first half, 15-13, Rochester. Grimmelsmacher holds above her head. Right wing behind the arc against Larkin. Drives it right. Goes to the basket. Shot is up and good, and we're tied at 15. Four-court press by the Kings. Holland back to Larkin. Quickly to Malco. Becky, one dribble. Back to Larkin, middle of the floor. Ahead to Holland. She crosses the timeline. Holland to paint. Gives to Stasiak. Stasiak steals it back from Cass. Puts it up. It's good.
Stasiak just fighting for the basketball.
That was like 2 turnovers in about 2 seconds.
You're right.
17-15 Rochester. Over the top of the defense of Collins. Quick 3. Right side. In and out. No good. Rebound to Stasiak. Keaton rips and runs.
If the Lady Zebras can continue to keep Collins on the perimeter, things will work out for them.
Yeah, I'm with you. I think that's where she'd like to play.
Yeah, I think you're right. I don't think she likes to get down low.
Larkin looks at a three, passes it up, passes to Malco, back to Larkin left side. She'll fire a three from the wing. Short. And the rebound to Holland. Nice job by Hannah Odell keeping that one alive. Malco will fire a three. It's short. And it goes in.
Bounced over the front of the rim.
20-15. Hit the front of the rim and went in. Would that be called a shooter's touch?
Yes, because there wasn't any roll on it.
Weaver over the top of the defense to Thompson. Now right side to Grimmelsbacher. Left wing to McLean. Down low to Weaver. Her layup is no good. Fought for. Larkin comes out of there with a board and gives to Malco. Rochester by five and runs to our left. 4:40 to play in the first half. Larkin outside left. Picks up a loose ball dribble. Now outside to Holland, and she has her pass kicked away by Thompson. It'll be out of bounds on the far side to Rochester.
You know, I would agree with you. Lewis Cass is by far not looking like a 1-4 team, but I think the larger this lead gets for the Lady Zebras as we head towards halftime, the more that 1-4 is going to start playing into their memory.
Holland for three is good!
Especially with shots like that from Holland.
And you got to think about now the foul situation for Lewis Cass.
Yeah, you're right.
23-15, Rochester's lead is 8, and then Holland just about picked the pocket. The ball's loose, and now we're going to have a foul on X. A little aggressive foul right there by Alexa Holland as she just about picked the pocket and then dove after the loose ball and then took the feet out from under McLean.
So Holland picks up her first. That's only the third for the Lady Zebras.
4:11 to play first half. Rochester by 8. Coming up at halftime, Rochester wrestling coach Clint Gard. You want to be listening for that. Weaver, her layup on the baseline is good. Full court press by Lewis Cass. And then the pass is stolen by Lewis Cass and then stolen back by Holland. X runs middle of the floor, picks her way through the defense. Now right side, pulls up and waits for the offense. Outside to Holland, fakes her, makes that Malco. Fakes the three, pulls up, jumper over Collins is no good. But a foul coming on Lewis Cass that's going to send Malco to the line to shoot two. 3:47 to play first half.
So that foul on Grimmelsbacher, her second.
And Becky Malco at the line to shoot two freebies for the Lady Zebras. As Morgan Ruff will come back in at the next opportunity, which is right now, as Malco hits the first free throw. She and Abbott is coming in. Larkin and Hannah Odell to sit. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. 3:47 to play first half. Rochester by 7. Malco with one more for the Lady Zebras. Malco eyes it, flies it. Good. 25-17. Rochester's biggest lead of the night is 8.
Malco had career-high 27 Saturday night against McConaughey.
And she had a pretty good game against LaVille, too, right?
Yeah.
McLean around the defense in the lane. Down low to Weaver. One dribble, has her pass stolen. Holland behind her back dribble. Works right side of the lane. Sugarland for the right-handed layup. It's good! And we're up by 10. Great ball handling there by Alexa Holland. And she went in for an uncontested layup. Backdoor pass to Grimmelsbacher. Then she throws the ball away into the hands of Malco. Malco right side of the floor. Stop. Left wing pass to Holland. Her layup is good. Timeout, Lewis Cass. 29-17 Rochester. It is a 60. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI. 3 minutes to play first half. Rochester on an 8-0 run. Leads by 12 at 29-17, and Kayton Stasiak commits a foul. She fouls Grimmelsbacher going to the basket. She'll go to the line to shoot two.
Stasiak's first. Team fourth.
Fantastic ball handling and team play in those last 4 points.
And the forced turnovers leading to easy buckets at the other end of the floor for the Lady Zebras.
Grimmelsbacher's first free throw is good. Nothing but net. Allie Larkin back into the game, and Stasiak to sit down. Hey, don't forget, tomorrow night, the Rochester guys open their season here at home against the Culver Cavaliers. Tony and I will have that broadcast for you at around 7:30-ish here on WROI. Maybe 7. Just depends how windy he is.
Yeah. Better go for 7.
Better go. We'll start our pregame right after this one's over.
Yeah.
10-point lead for Rochester. Holland works to the left elbow, kicks it out to Malco, who drives the paint, down low to Ruff. Ruff throws a shot, no good, rebound by Rochester. Holland, 10-footer left side, is way off the mark, all nothing but air.
He needs to back up.
And then Cass pushes it down the floor.
Ooh, gets away with the travel.
Widener to Thompson, against a double team, throws it up for grabs. Larkin comes out of there with it. Crossover dribble, works ahead to Holland. 2:20 to play, first half, Rochester by 10. Holland gets a pick, works left side, now drives it to the baseline, and before the shot, she'll be fouled, and she'll go to the line to shoot two, and I believe Grimmelsbacher is going to pick up a foul.
That'll be her third.
So quick. These guards are so quick.
Yep.
Shooting two for the Zebras. 2:11 to play, first half. Rochester by 10. Holland back on the line this time, shooting two for the Lady Zebras. Eyes it, flies it, good.
It's her eighth point here in this quarter.
And
she's got 10 for the ball game.
Holland with one more. Sets herself, fires the second one, it's short. And the rebound to Collins, who gives off now to McLean. Cass runs to our right. Rochester up by 11. McLean picks her way through the defense. Outside to Grimmelsbacher in the corner. To Widener, her three is off the mark. Ugh. The last thing she wanted to do is shoot an air ball at the student section the way they are.
Right in front of the student section.
Malco for three, left wing. Oh, no good. Rebound fought for, and Morgan Ruff is going to come out of there with a foul.
He's going to pick up a bad foul.
And it'll be out of bounds to Lewis Cass underneath the Rochester basket.
Long bounce off the rim.
Stasiak back in, Morgan Ruff to come out. 1:50 to play, first half. Rochester by 11, and the Lady Kings of the basketball going to our right. McLean jogs it up the floor, now crosses the timeline, works down to the right side. On the wing, backs it outside over the top of the defense. Grimmelsbacher has her shot partially blocked, picked up by Holland. Holland now slows up and runs with 90 seconds to play in the first half with Rochester up by 11. Through the center circle, more than likely Rochester will run some clock here. Holland works to the left side. Left side to Larkin with a minute 20. Larkin to the paint. Stops. Pops. Shot short. Rebound. Fall forward. Thompson comes out of there with it. Lewis Cass has it. Thompson up the floor for the Lady Kings. Outside left to Weaver. Nope. To Grimmelsbacher. Down low to Collins. Collins shot no good. Partially blocked by Abbott.
Nice.
Picked up by Larkin.
By
yep. Stood her ground. Didn't give anything.
Didn't swat at anything. Collins held that ball out in front of her.
Minute to play. Malco around the defense and is going to be fouled by Widener. And she'll go to the line to shoot two with 57.7 to play in the first half.
Holly Widener at the line for the Zebras, shooting two. Number 20, Becky Malco.
Becky Malco at the line for two for Rochester. Looking to push this lead to 13. Eyes the first one, lets it fly, and it's good. Weaver coming back into the game for Lewis Cass and Grimmelsbacher to come out. One more coming for the junior, Becky Malco. Misses the second one too hard, and the rebound to Collins. McLean pushes for the Kings. Rochester up by 12. McLean around the defense. Gives outside to Thompson. A long three for the Lady Kings. And draws nothing but air. And Larkin to the rebound. 45 seconds of play, first half. Rochester by 12. Malco through the center circle. Then has her pocket picked by Thompson. Thompson left side of the floor. Goes up for the shot. It is good.
Number 10, Savannah.
31-21. 30 to play in the first half. Clint Gard, Rochester wrestling coach, coming up here in a bit. Malco through the center circle. Works against Widener. Takes to the left wing at the elbow. Now kicks it out to Holland with 18. X holds with 16. X drives right side with 14. Now backs it off to the center circle with 12. Gives off to Larkin with 10. Allie drives it left with 8. Allie picks up her dribble with 7. Gives it the corner to Malco with 5. Drives the baseline. Pull-up jumper over Collins is no good. And the rebound is Stasiak. Ball loose with 1, and that's going to do it for the first half. At halftime, Rochester leads 31-21. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Buying your first home? Let the experts at First Federal Savings Bank help you through the process. At First Federal, all of their mortgage loans are serviced locally, with payment options that are convenient for you. Their staff will work with you, answering your questions and providing professional service. First Federal will even pay standard closing costs for qualifying first-time homebuyers. Just another way First Federal takes care of you, your local mortgage lender. At Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester, it's our customers that come first.
Shepherd's made my buying process easy. The sales staff at Shepherd's was extremely knowledgeable and helped me find the right vehicle at a price that fit my budget. They had a great selection of new and pre-owned vehicles to choose from, and they gave me a great deal on my trade-in. I wouldn't shop anywhere but Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester. They really are my local hometown dealer.
Back at Rochester High School, going to the third quarter. Brad, first half numbers.
For the Lady Kings, Thompson with 6. Grimmelsbacher with 4. McCain, 2. Weaver, 2. Collins, 3. Young, 2. And Humer Rickhouse, 2. That's all one word. The Lady Kings, Gremmelsbacher with three, and Aubrey Young with four. Weaver with two fouls. For the Lady Zebras, Holland with 10, Stasiak 7, Malco 8, Abbott 1, Larkin 5, and only Morgan Ruff with two fouls.
Third quarter we go with Rochester up by 10, and the Lady Zebras will start with the basketball and will work against the 2-3 zone. Malco runs the point, now drifts to the right side, cross court left wing to pass to Holland. X1 dribble back to Malco between the rings. She drives it to the right side over the top of the defense to Holland left wing. Holland middle of the floor, back to Malco, right side. Malco bounce pass to in the corner to Larkin. Back to Malco, quickly left side to Larkin. Now the corner to Stasiak. Keaton wraparound pass down low to Abbott. Outside to Holland for three, left wing is short. And the rebound to Stasiak. Keaton with the basketball, gives it to Malco in the paint. Outside to Larkin and throws it away. 7:25 to play. Third quarter, Rochester by 10 in the first turnover of the half. Thompson works around Malco, drives her to the left side of the floor. Now to the baseline, throws up a shot over Bailey Abbott. It's in and out and back in. And Cass strikes first in his second to half and cuts the lead to 8. Here comes the full-court press by Lewis Cass.
They've had some good success with that early on in the ballgame, first quarter.
Holland across the timeline. Wraparound pass to Abbott. Now back door to Malco. Wrap around pass to Stasiak. Layup is good. Rochester back up by 10.
Good ball movement by the Lady Zebras.
Well, they got Collins off the block.
Yep.
And basically the ball went to where Collins came from. Collins for three. Left wing is no good. Too hard. Rebound to McLean. Gremmelsbacher will fire her own three. It's no good. Good block out by Larkin. Malco now the board.
Collins had an early three-pointer in this ballgame, and she's been quiet ever since.
Larkin high on the left side, backs it out, gives it to Holland between the rings. In the corner to Stasiak. Stasiak drives the baseline, cross-court pass to Malco. Malco outside to Larkin, thought about a three, passes it up and gives it to Holland, who's at the free throw line.
Carry
and X carries it. 33-23 Rochester, 6:10 to play in the third.
The Lady Kings doing a good job staying fronted up on defense, and the Lady Zebras trying to do those little swing-around passes. That time, X got caught with the carry.
Collins for three. Good again. Her second one of the night. Cuts the lead to 7. You leave her that much time, she's going to bury him. Malco back to Larkin. Ahead to Holland. X. Middle of the floor for Rochester against the double team. Works left side to Larkin behind the arc. Allie, couple of dribbles to Malco between the rings, top of the key. Reset, swings left side to Holland. Now to back to Malco. Becky, couple of dribbles to Larkin. Back to Becky, left side to Holland. She'll take a three left wing. It's good, and we're back to 10.
Holland with her second three-pointer in the ballgame.
Collins must have been a two.
Oh.
And then the pass is stolen by Holland. X, right side of the floor, right-handed layup is good. Rochester by 13, 38-25. And then Holland steals the pass again. X,
dribble out for a three.
Wide open three, good! Timeout, Lewis Cass.
8 points.
It is a 60.
8 points for Holland in about 10 seconds.
You're listening to Ladies Ear Basketball, 92.1 WROI. 5:08 to play in the third. Rochester now up 41-25.
Alexa Holland channeling Reggie Miller there with 8 points in about 10-second span as she hits a three, then a steal and the layup, and then another steal, and she has the presence of mind to step back behind the three-point arc.
Well, they gave her enough time.
Yeah.
I mean, she could have cooked a meal out there.
She was pulling the back out front waiting for her teammates, and when they didn't show, she
just took
the shot.
We'll just chuck it. Four-court press by the Lady Zebras. McLean over the top of the defense of Gremmelsbacher, right side of the floor, behind the arc, spots up, she'll fire her own three. It's good as it rattles in.
She's actually on the line. I'm surprised they called
two.
Yep.
But I thought Collins had a three as well and marked her for two.
Right.
Stasiak throws it away, and then Gremmelsbacher travels. 4:46 to play in the third. Rochester up 41-28.
The thing about this Lady Kings team is no matter how aggressively you play the ball, they're going to match you. I don't think any lead is going to be safe against this team.
2-3 zone. Larkin drives it inside the 2-3 zone to Holland. X back to Larkin, left wing. Now right wing to Malco. She drives it inside the defense, outside to X. Wide open three, left wing. It's good!
Lexa Holland with her third three-pointer in this third quarter.
Give her the rock. She's hot.
Yeah, fourth for the ball game.
44-28. Rochester up with 4:15 to play in the third. Grimmelsbacher, top of the key to Thompson. Rochester in a man-to-man defense. Drives it right, outside to Weaver against Stasiak, top of the key to McLean. McLean, down low to Weaver. She's going to be fouled on the shot by Stasiak, and that's going to send Weaver to the line to shoot two. Boy, I thought maybe she got away with the travel before the foul.
So. I thought so, too. That was Stasiak's second.
So going to the line will be Carly Weaver, the 5'6 senior for the Lewis Cass Lady Kings. First time tonight she's there. Eyes the first one, lets it fly. It's short. Hits the front of the rim, the backboard, and it goes through. One more coming for the senior, the lone senior on this Lewis Cass team. Weaver ready, eyes the second one, lets it fly. Good again. 44-30. Rochester with the basketball and the lead with 4:07 to play in the third quarter. Larkin will bring it up the floor. Now back to Malco. Becky, a couple of dribbles over the top to Larkin, down low to Stasiak, Keaton against the defense, short, no good. Gets her own rebound in the paint, kicks it outside to Larkin from the free throw line. Her jumper's on the way and good. Rochester lead back to 16 with 3:47 to play in the third. Thompson picks her way through the defense, goes to the left block, throws up a shot, no good. Larkin rips the board and runs. Allie Larkin, left side of the floor, crosses the timeline, now works to the wing, now inside the three-point line, cut off by the defense. Bounce pass to Malco, and then Coach Stasiak will use a 30-second timeout. You're listening to Rochester Basketball, 92.1 WROI. 3.5 to play in the third quarter. Rochester up by 16 at 46-30. And after the Rochester timeout, they'll have the basketball going to our right.
Lexa Holland with 3 three-pointers in this quarter, 4 for the basketball game. She's got 21 points.
Lewis Cass down to 2 timeouts. In this game, yeah, she's had a decent third quarter.
Yeah, absolutely.
Fair. Larkin behind the arc, right side against Lewis Cass's 2-3 zone. Now back to Holland. Chuck it again. I don't care how many people you got defending you. Just chuck it.
She wanted to.
Malco bounced past to Larkin behind the arc, right wing. Now drives it to the baseline, and then is going to be fouled by Grimmelsbacher.
Grimmelsbacher picks up her fourth.
And that's 4. That's 2.
Yeah, 2 now with 4.
Yeah.
Of course, Aubrey Young was coming off the bench filling in for Grimmelsbacher, and that's the reason why she's still in.
I think she picked them all up in the first quarter, didn't she?
Yes, she did.
Larkin gets the inbounds pass from Holland, gives to Malco, left side, quick 3 for the Lady Zebras. It's short. Malco gets her own rebound. Becky drives in the paint, pass down low to Stasiak. Her jumper inside of the lane is good.
Great job by Malco getting her own rebound. She drew Collins off the block. She had to come up to stop Malco, and she found Stasiak wide open.
Collins fakes a 3, drives it, goes to the basket, loses the handle. They're picked up by Weaver in the backcourt. Weaver then to Grimmelsbacher. Her pass is tipped away by Stasiak out of bounds. It'll stay with Lewis Cass right in front of their own bench. And coming into the game is Widener. And Grimmelsbacher with 4 fouls will come out. Rochester's at their biggest lead of the night of 18 with 2:40 to play in the third. Widener gets it in to McLean. McLean dribbles around the defense and has her pass stolen by Malco. Becky Malco stops. Cross lane pass to Holland. Her layup is good. Rochester up by 20. 50-30. Lewis Cass will use a timeout. 2:27 to play in the third. It is a 30. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI. 2:27 to play in the third quarter. Rochester up 50-30. Lewis Cass has 1 timeout left. Rochester has 4. The JV game tonight went to Rochester over Lewis Cass 44-28. Kennedy Musselman, 16 points and 12 boards in that contest. Maddie Shively had 10 for the Lady Zebras, who are now 4-1 JV-wise. Lost her first game of the regular season against Twin Lake, 42-40, and has won ever since. Wide open back door to Collins. Layup is good.
Lady Zebras kind of fell asleep in their zone.
Sleeping. Full court press by Lewis Cass. Stasiak, middle of the floor, pulls it back outside to Larkin. Straight away, 3 on the way. In and out, no good. Rebound tipped around. Cass comes out of the with it. Widener down to McLean. McLean, middle of the floor, works to the right side of the lane. Outside to Thompson. Her feet on the line. Her jumper's in and out, no good. And the ball being tipped around, and we're going to have an out-of-bounds call. Last touch by Weaver. It's going to go back to Rochester. Boy, Keaton worked hard. Working
he has
hard.
Been working hard.
Morgan Ruff will come in, and Keaton will sit down. I don't know if she has any points to show, but she's been working hard.
Yeah, she's got 11 now for the Lady Zebras. Yeah, she's probably got that many rebounds as well.
Huh. I swear I'm watching the same game. Malka through the center circle, goes to the paint, goes all the way to the rack, layup is good. Rochester back up by 20.
That's the third one in doubles now for the Lady Zebras as Malka now has 10.
52-32 Rochester, 100 seconds to play in the third. The pass is tipped away and stolen by Ruff. Morgan, middle of the floor now for Rochester. Ruff in the paint, jump pass down low to Bailey Abbott. Back to Malka, her shot is no good, but a foul coming on Cass, and it's going to send Malco to the line to shoot two.
I think I would have liked to rather seen Abbott shoot that one.
I agree.
She had the better angle.
Number 10, Savannah.
That foul is on Thompson, her second.
Shooting two for the Zebras, Becky Malco.
Malco to the line to shoot two. First on the way is no good. She'll have one more. Yay! 20-point lead is the biggest of the night for Rochester. Malco with a one free throw. Second one looks better. It is better. 53-32. 90 seconds to play in the third quarter. We're getting Keaton's rebounds.
Corner.
Here comes a half-court trap around the defense. Ball goes to McLean. Thank you. Now to Weaver in the baseline. And the high pass back to McLean. High on the right side for Lewis Cass. McLean tries to dribble away from trouble. Pass is stolen again by Ruff. Morgan, middle of the floor. Rochester with the numbers. Morgan, jump pass down low to Larkin. Her shot's no good, but a foul coming on Lewis Cass. It's going to send Larkin to the line to shoot two.
Again, great ball movement by the Lady Zebras.
Keen has seven boards.
And that foul on McLean, her second.
Alexa Garrison will come back in after the first free throw by Allie Larkin. One dribble, free throw on the way is good. Garrison back in, and coming out of the game is Bailey Abbott. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. A minute 8 to play in the third. Rochester up by 22. One more for the junior. Second one's good again. 55-32 Rochester. And Lewis Castle will bring it up, and Malco will look to pick up McLean right at the timeline. McLean works left side to Thompson. Thompson holds high on the left side. Now back to McLean, high on the right side of the volleyball line. Under a minute to play in the first third quarter. Widener, down low to Collins. Jumper over Ruff is good. That might have been a mismatch. 55-34, 45 to play in the third. Rochester up and with the basketball. Holland, top of the key against McLean. Takes her to the elbow, kicks it outside to Malco. Becky, a couple of dribbles. Down low to Ruff. Morgan backs the way in. She's fouled on the shot. She'll go to the line to shoot two.
Widener picking up her second.
Why not?
Yep.
34 and a half to play in the third. Rochester at 55-34. And Morgan Ruff at the line to shoot two for the Lady Zebras. First one of the way is good. Nothing but net. One more coming for the freshman. Morgan eyes it, flies it. Good. 57-34. 30 seconds to play, third quarter. Cast of the basketball. Rochester the lead. McLean through the center circle. Down low to wide open. Collins runs right around Alexa Garrison, and she puts it up, and good for two.
Collins, with only 3 points up through halftime, now has 8 in this quarter, 11 for the game.
57-36, 12 seconds. Holland backs it out of the center circle with 10. Holland dribbles with 9. Holland gives to Ruff with 7. Morgan Ruff holds with 5. Morgan Ruff holds with 3. Drives it right with 2. Goes to the basket with 1. Layup is good, and that's going to do for the third. After 3, Rochester up 59-36. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
First Federal Savings Bank is Rochester's only locally owned bank. Stop in today to start a new checking or savings account. Learn more about our online banking options or sign up for Go Green Checking, the checking account that pays you back every time you use your card. Stop in today to see why local banking is better banking. First Federal Savings Bank, serving Rochester and surrounding communities since 1966. After 64 years serving this community, B&B Menswear of Rochester is closing their doors. Now is the time to save on all men's apparel as they liquidate their inventory. Take advantage of their store-wide savings on slacks, shirts, shoes, and more. Stop in today to see Phil, John, or Margaret as the B&B store clears its inventory of their name brand menswear. B&B store is going out of business and passing the savings on to you. Stop by today and save.
Fourth and final quarter we go here at Rochester High School. And Lady Zebras own a 59-36 lead. And Lewis Cass starts the fourth and final quarter of the basketball. And immediately
Fouled by Malco.
Yeah.
That's her second.
Becky Malco picks up a foul. It'll be out of bounds to Lewis Cass on the far side. Weaver in the corner. Just about has her pass stolen away, but McLean has it. Gives it back to Weaver on the baseline. And then throws it out of bounds. Last touch by McLean. Rochester going to get it back. Great defense by Morgan Ruff on that far side, taking away the passing lane. And Rochester going to get it back. Up 59-20, makes that 59-36 with a 7:45 to play in the game. Ruff to bring it up the floor, right through the center circle, runs away from the defense. Garrison down low on the blocks, puts a shot up on the glass, no good, gets a row rebound, and we're going to have a tie-up, and it's going to stay with Rochester. Grimmelspacher back into the game for Lewis Cass, and Weaver to come out. 7:36 to play in the game. Rochester up by 23.
Freshman Morgan Ruff doing a great job bringing the ball up the floor, working through the defense.
I think she probably could have had a layup if she'd have. And then the inbounds pass comes down to Bailey Abbott. She puts it up for two.
Well, she did have the layup there at the end of the third quarter.
Grimmelspacher down low, pass tipped away by Abbott out of bounds. It'll stay with Lewis Cass as Larkin and X comes back in. Abbott and Ruff to sit. I'm sorry, Malco and Ruff to sit. 7:23 to play in the game. Don't forget the Rochester guys open their season tomorrow night here at Rochester High School. They will play the Culver Cavaliers. You can hear that game here on WROI. Holland then steals the inbounds pass, leads ahead to Larkin. Allie Larkin, right side of the floor. Her layup is on the way and good.
Larkin now the fourth starter for the Lady Zebras in doubles.
63-36, bounce pass to Grimmelsmacher, and her pass is stolen away by Larkin. Allie, right side of the floor. Rochester the numbers, gives to X. Left-handed layup on the way is good again. Now Lewis Cass runs it up the floor quickly. Outside of Collins. Collins just inside the three-point line, short jumper short. Bailey Abbott the rebound. Holland with the basketball. Now Coach Stasiak says, hey, let's blow up a little bit. We're up 65-39.
Hold out.
Stasiak at the elbow left, outside to Larkin. Wide open three, passes it up, gives to Stasiak, drives the baseline. Wrap around pass to Garrison. Her layup is good and a foul.
Alexa Garrison.
Her first points of the season. Alexa Garrison will go to the line to shoot one for the Lady Zebras.
Number 20.
The foul against Grimmelsbacher. That's her fifth.
At the line, shooting one.
Back into the game is Young. And coming out of the game is Grimmelsbacher with five fouls. Becky Malco will come back in for Rochester. And coming out is Alexa Holland.
Holland, 25 points tonight in the ballgame.
A lot of action in the second and third quarters.
Yes, absolutely.
Garrison at the line for one free throw. Sophomore eyes it. Flies it. Good.
She had 21 of her 25 in those two quarters.
68-36. Rochester on top with 3:35 to play. I'm sorry, 6:35 to play in the game. McLean to Thompson to McLean. Fakes the three. Looks at passes up. Gives to Collins. Back to McLean. Back top of the key. Outside to Thompson. She'll fire a three left wing. It's off the mark. No good. Rebound skied for it. And grabbed by Thompson. But
yep,
on the shot. Before the shot, Thompson's fouled on the reach in by Bailey Abbott.
Abbott picks up her first.
6:19 to play in the game. Rochester up 68-36. Morgan Ruff will come back into the next opportunity. Thompson throws up a shot, no good. The rebound offensively by McLean, and then Keaton Stasiak knocks it out of bounds. Morgan Ruff comes into the game, and Ruff replaces Garrison for the Lady Zebras. Six 14 to play in the basketball game. The inbounds pass comes over to Young in the corner to Collins. The fadeaway jumper is good for made by 18 feet, and it's 68-38. Full court press by the Kings. Malco through the center circle, works to the right wing, by Hunter back dribble, switches directions, works left side. Holland will come back into the game. Holland to make that Malco, splits the defense in the paint, got to get rid of it, got to get out of there, outside the rough. Morgan on the wing. Works against Young, and then Young has just fouled out.
Yep, she did. That's the second. One to foul out for the Lady Kings.
5:46 to play in the game. Rochester by 30. Holland will come back in. As will Weaver. Bailey Abbott comes out. 5:46 to play in the game. Rochester up 68-38. Rochester basketball baseline left. Holland looks to get it in over the top of the defense to Larkin. Allie, top of the key, hesitates. Still behind the three-point line, gives it to Stasiak. Keaton, crossover dribble, goes to the lane, now pulls it out, will run some clock. She works against the man-to-man defense, and that's Collins. Stasiak, her shot on the way, Collins picks up a foul, she'll go to the lane to shoot two.
Collins picks up her first.
So Keaton will go to the line to shoot two with Rochester up by 30. Keaton ready. Eyes her first one. Lets it fly. It's good.
Keaton with 12 now in the ball game.
Four Lady Zebras in doubles. That's pretty cool.
Yes.
All of them working hard. Keaton Satan, second one is good again. Lady Zebras will take a 30-second timeout. You're listening to Rochester Basketball, 92.1 WROI. 5:34 to play in the game. Rochester up 70-38, and it'll be Lewis Cass basketball going to our left. Again, our next broadcast tomorrow night. The Rochester guys will open their season at home with Culver. Rochester's next action after this one is at Winamac, which ought to be interesting, on Saturday night.
Homecoming, is it, for a couple of young ladies?
Well, is the homecoming
Not really.
Yeah, I'll say that.
I don't know.
Yeah. It'll be interesting, to say the least.
Interesting. That's a better word.
70-38 Rochester, and then Lewis Cass turns it over. Malco gives out to Holland. Alexa holds. Now dribbles a couple of times, middle of the floor, in the paint, kicks it out to Ruff. 5 minutes to play in the game. Morgan drives it at the free throw line. Still down low. Ball taken away by Collins. Now quickly to Thompson. Thompson for the Kings. Outside to Widener. Widener drives and fouled by Ruff on the reach. Foul on the block, I should say. That'll be out of bounds to Lewis Cass with 4:49 to play in the basketball game. Again, Rochester up 70-38.
Ruff picks up her third.
McLean will look to trigger it in. Baseline left. McLean studies over the top of the defense to Thompson. High on the left side. Back to McLean between the ring. Down low. Ball tipped away and stolen by Malco, tipped away by Larkin.
Yep, nice job by Larkin.
Bailey Abbott will come in after the next dead ball. Reminder back dribble to Malco, takes her to the lane. Cut off by the defense. Outside to Holland, exit the elbow right, gives him the corner to Ruff. Morgan holds against the man-to-man defense, drives the baseline, throws it away, right into the hands of Thompson, and Rochester gives up the ball again. Thompson runs for the Kings. Stop, pop, nope. Rebound to Holland. X now will slow it up. Jog it through the center circle with 4:10 to play in the basketball game. Rochester up 70-38. I wouldn't be surprised here if Coach Stasiak goes to his bench here momentarily. Larkin in the paint outside to Holland, who's had a fantastic basketball game.
You know, Morgan Ruff, the move in from Winamac, a freshman this year. She's not been around Coach Stasiak very much just this season, and yet they still have those. As Larkin goes up to the layaround, misses, Stasiak puts it back in. But they have that nonverbal communication. She throws the ball away on the previous possession, and Stasiak doesn't say a word to her. He just looks at her, and she nods her head. She understands.
Yes, Coach, got it. Holland steals the basketball. 72-38, had a breakaway layup, and we'll pull it out and run some time. Malco holds at the volleyball line. Clock runs. Pressure's applied. Count starts. Gives it to the volleyball line, or makes up the elbow, and sends outside to Holland. X. Now to Larkin, who holds with the volleyball line. 3:17 to play in the game. Rochester up 72-38. Alexa Garrison will come back into the game. Larkin in the center circle against Collins. Crossover dribble takes her left. Now bounce pass to Holland, high on the left side. X to Malco in the center circle. Number three to play. Malco in the paint. Loses the handle. Right into the hands of Stasiak. She puts a shot up. No lot of contact, no foul. And they're going to say the ball is knocked out of bounds. Last touch by Lewis Cass. It's Abbott and Garrison in. Stasiak and Larkin, I would say, are done. And Coach Collins will go to his bench.
Stasiak with 15 points in the ball game today. Larkin with 11.
Thompson is done. And into the game for the first time is Logan Henry. Holland looks to the inbounds, baseline left. Bounce pass to a wide open Larkin that has it taken away. Now McLean quickly up the floor. Gives it to Collins. Spot up three, right wing. Good. 72-41, Rochester. 2:40 to play in the game. Malco up the floor. Stops at the three-point line, switches directions. Now brings it to the Rochester bench. At the volleyball line and dribbles. Against the man-to-man defense. 2:26 to play in the game. Outside to Ruff at the center circle. Rochester up 72-41. Bounce pass to Holland with 2:15 to play in the game. Malco now holds. Coach Stasiak's going to make a line change. And then we'll use a... Rochester will use a timeout just to get some kids in and kids, more importantly, the starters out who had a fantastic basketball game.
Yeah, Holland with 25 leads all scorers in the book right now.
Number 34, Hannah.
Four of the starters for the Lady Zebras in double digits. So good effort all around for the Lady Zebras tonight.
So Grace Pfeiffer in the game. Odell back in. Kennedy Musselman in the game as well. As Grace gets it into Ruff. Morgan at the three-point line. Works to the right side of the volleyball court. Now stands right at the R in the volleyball, or in the floor. Runs around the defense in the paint. Kicks it back outside and runs clock. Right side pass to Pfeiffer. Down low to Musselman. Kennedy then out for fingertips and out of bounds. And it'll go back to Lewis Cass. A minute 53 to play in the game. Rochester up 72-41. Henry quickly up the floor. Stops at the elbow. Is that Dieter? Yeah, Dieter outside to Widener.
There's a giant parking lot.
Man-to-man defense by the Lady Zebras. Widener with the basketball. Outside left to Dieter. Dieter dribbles to the volleyball line and 90 seconds of play in the game. And the pass down low is tipped away and stolen by Odell. It's going to be tied up between Odell and Humerick House. And it'll stay with Lewis Cass. Morgan Ruff is done. Alexa Garrison is done. Alexa Elliott comes in, as does Emma Dahlquist. Humerick House looks to get it in. Does so around Kennedy to Reidner. Reidner goes to the basket. She's fouled on the shot. She'll go to the line to shoot two.
Dahlquist going to pick up a foul. That's her first.
Minute 20 to play in the game. Rochester up 72-41. And at the free throw line is Holly Widener, the 5'6 freshman for the Lewis Cass Lady Kings. Left-handed free throw shooter. Eyes the first one. Lets it fly. And it's no good.
The only points the Lady Kings have in this quarter are the two buckets from Collins.
Say it again.
The only points this quarter were the two buckets from Collins.
Wow. Second for Widener. No good. Rebound to Musselman, who rips it away from Collins and gives off to Pfeiffer.
The way this game started, I never thought they would run out of gas. But
who, Cass?
Yeah.
Yeah,
They just aren't deep enough to keep that pace up against this defense for the Lady Zebras.
Well, I'm not sure if they have any scores outside of Collins.
Right,
I mean, nobody looked to score.
Yeah, you're right.
Pass goes off the legs of Lewis Cass, thankfully. Cass or Rochester will keep it right in front of the Rochester bench. Pfeiffer looks to bounce, pass it in, does so to Elliott. Lexi on the right baseline, dribbles now to the wing with a minute to play in the game. Lexi gets a pick, now works to the middle of the floor against the man-to-man defense, gets a pick from Musselman, bounce pass to Pfeiffer, back to Elliott. Lexi backs it out between the rings, 45 to play in the game, gets a pick from Dahlquist. Over the top of the defense to Pfeiffer, outside to Elliott. Lexi holds with 38. Drives it left to the elbow, cut off by the defense. Down low to Musselman. Kennedy backs her way in, throws up a shot. It's no good. Gets her own rebound. The put back off the window is good. 74-41. 27 to play in the game. Henry drives all the way into the paint. Cut off by the double team. Out to Collins. Jumper on the way, no good. And the rebound to Musselman, and she'll go to the line to shoot free throws as she is fouled by Humerick House. With 17.7 to play in the game, with Rochester up 74-41. Kennedy had a fantastic JV game. 16 points, 12 rebounds for the freshman.
In their win,
yep, their 44-28 win. Kennedy at the line for one of the bonus. Freshman eyes it, flies it, good.
Look at that rotation.
Absolutely. We lay on the floor and then on the bed and practice rotation.
There you go.
Second one on the way is good again. 76-41. 15 seconds to play. Widener. Left side to Young. No good. Rebound to Elliott with 7. Lexi runs with 6. With 4, with 3, with 2, and that'll do it. Rochester defeats Lewis Cass tonight. 76-41. Post-game show coming up next on 92.1 WROI.
buying your first home? Let the experts at First Federal Savings Bank help you through the process. At First Federal, all of their mortgage loans are serviced locally, with payment options that are convenient for you. Their staff will work with you, answering your questions and providing professional service. First Federal will even pay standard closing costs for qualifying first-time homebuyers. Just another way First Federal takes care of you, your local mortgage lender. At Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester, it's our customers that come first.
I've been buying vehicles at Shepherd Chevrolet for over 16 years. They've always had the vehicle I wanted at a price that I could afford. I trust Shepherd's sales staff to give me the best price and the best financing available. From my work trucks to my personal vehicle, Shepherd's is the only choice for me. Stop out to Shepherd Chevrolet today to get your next vehicle. They really are my local hometown Chevy dealer.